Components, as we've learned, are at the heart of Angular. When composing our application, our components form a tree-like structure in which these components become nested. These nested or child components need a way of receiving data from its parent as well as sending data back to its parent. In order to accomplish this, Angular provides us with inputs and outputs. Let's first focus on inputs. Input is a decorator used inside of a child component that allows data to flow from a parent component into the child component. Whenever a nested component wants to receive input from its container, it must expose a property next to an input decorator. And this exposed property then gets binded to a value in the parent. So inside of our child component, we first need to import the input decorator. And then inside of our class, we invoke our input here. And then we create a property of whatever we want, in this case, named reviews. So this property can be anything. And you can think of it like a variable that's going to represent some value we get from the parent. And then we need to define its type, which in this case is a number. So this property called reviews is going to contain a number of reviews given to us by the parent. In our current application, we're displaying the number of book reviews in our template using book.bookReviews, and the property in our class looks like this. Now the way that we're able to gain reference to book reviews in our child component is by creating a binding inside of our child selector. So inside our parent component HTML file, here we add our child selector referencing the child component and then add a binding. So we wrap the reviews property we defined inside of square brackets and then set it equal to a value inside of the parent. So now our reviews child property has been assigned the value of book reviews. And this means that inside of our child HTML file, we can now reference the reviews property, which is going to be populated with the parent value. So if we're using interpolation here, we would see the number 15 displayed in our child template. So let's now practice using inputs inside of our application. Okay, so let's practice adding inputs to our application. So for this and the next example, I'm going to be using a favorites component. So let's go ahead and create that. And I'm going to create it in our app folder. So I'll say new folder, and we're going to call this favorites. Then inside of our favorites folder, I want to create a TypeScript file and an HTML file. So I'll right click that and say new file. And we're going to name this favorite.component.ts. And create another new file, which will be favorite.component.html. And I'm going to start in my HTML file. I'm going to add just a simple tag in order to make sure that this component is working. So we'll just say hello world here. Now I'm going to go back into my favorite component and we'll add our setup code. So we're going to be importing both component and input. And this is going to be from Angular core. Next, I'm going to export our class. And the name of our class is going to be favorite component. And then we'll go ahead and create our component decorator. And first we'll say module ID is module.id. Next we'll declare a selector, which is going to be called BS favorite. And then finally, we'll list our template URL, which is located in the same folder and is called favorite.component.html. And the next thing I'll do is add this component into our app module declarations. So opening up my app module.ts file, I'm just going to copy this over and change this around. So we're going to be in the favorites folder. And this will be our favorite component. And this is called favorite component is our class. And then we'll make sure to add this to our array of declarations as favorite component. So now I just want to test out that our favorite component is working. And to do that, I'll open up our books list HTML file. And I'm going to add our favorite component child selector right below this div row. So we'll say div container. And then inside here, we'll say bs-favorite, which is the name of the selector. And then I'm just going to save this. And we should expect to see the hello world that we defined in our HTML file to appear right below the row. So I'll save that. And take a look at our application. And you can see that we're getting hello world as we expected. Now let's go ahead and add our input. So inside our favorite component, I'm going to declare our input by using our at declaration. And the property that I want to create is called reviews, which is of type number. And now we can use this reviews inside of the book list HTML file right inside of where a selector is. So what we need to do first is wrap our property in square brackets. And then we need to set it equal to a value inside of the parent. So we can choose really any of these. Book title, book author, book description. But since we want to show reviews, we'll say book.bookReviews. And we'll go ahead and save this. But what I haven't done is I haven't used this reviews property in the favorite component HTML file just yet. So what we can do is we can use this however we want, and we'll use interpolation. So now we should expect to see hello world and then a number of reviews, which will be the number 15. So let's go ahead and save that and look at our application. So it's actually not appearing. And if I look up our console, we're getting an error and it says cannot read property book reviews of undefined. So the reason is we go back into our books list HTML is that we haven't yet declared what book reviews is. So this is outside of the div where our ng4 is defining what book reviews actually is. So that's why we get the error. So what we can do is we can just copy this in. So I'm just going to cut this and then I'm going to paste this right below this ng4. So by pasting this below the ng4, which defines this book.bookReviews, now this should work. So I'll go ahead and save that. So when we reload our application, you can see that we are now getting the interpolated value of 15 inside of our child component.